My name is Tangwa Moses, an engineering student from KNUST. I must say thank you very much for the work you are doing, and I wish you all the best in your mission. Please, in your lecture, you made mention that you believe in Jesus Christ, that he was, listen, born miraculously. He gave life to the dead. And I must say, all the religions say man must die once before the said judgment day. If Jesus gave life to this man, was it just to show off because the man is no more living again? So why should Jesus give life to the person so that the person will die again? Meaning the person died twice. So was it just to show off, or what was it? Or he's still living? He didn't die again.
The brother asked a very good question, that we Muslims believe that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, gave life to the dead. So if Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, gave life to the dead, a person dies only once. So did Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, give life to the dead to show off? Why did he do it? I agree with you, a person dies only once. Quran says in Surah Imran chapter 3 verse number 185, Kullu nafsin zaiqatul maut. Every soul shall have a taste of death. And Quran says, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, Biznillah, wake up in the name of Allah, and he gave life to the dead. The Bible says that. But all the miracles done by all the prophets of God, right from start till Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were done by Almighty God. They were not done by the Prophet himself, but they were done by Almighty God. When Moses, peace be upon him, when he parted the sea, that miracle was done by Almighty God to prove to the followers that he is a messenger of God. And you can see this when you read the Bible. And when you know, once Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, when a person dies and two sisters go to Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, tell him that please save my brothers. So he prays to Almighty God that you listen to me. He cries, you are the one who can save him. Let this cup pass away from me. He's praying to Almighty God. That me asking God to give back life to that man. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is praying to Almighty God that when the life was given to the dead, it was given by Almighty God. So all the miracles that were done, they were done by Almighty God. And Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, was a messenger. So all the miracles that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, did, Moses, peace be upon him, did, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, did, these miracles are signs of Almighty God given so that his followers will understand he is a messenger of God. And this is mentioned in the Bible, in the book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22. Listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God amongst you, by wonders and miracles and signs which God did by him, and you witness to it. A man. It's mentioned in the book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22. Ye men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God amongst you, by miracles and wonders and signs which God did by him, and you witness to it. That means all these miracles God did just to prove that he was a messenger of God. That doesn't make that person God. That doesn't make that person superior. So all the miracles that were done by messengers were done by Almighty God as a sign to show that he is a messenger of God. Hope that answers the question, brother.
Meaning the person died twice.
That person died twice. Miracle means exception to the rule.
And please, Jesus asked God for something in the Bible which God didn't also do.
Sorry?
The night before Jesus was crucified in the Bible, Jesus went into the garden and prayed so that God could have changed things. You could see, the Bible says that he sweat. Even on the cross, you could see that it wasn't a willing thing. But God didn't do that for Jesus at that time. So I don't see it like Jesus would say, oh, come out of death. Then God did it there. But Jesus went into the garden, prayed, God didn't do. Which is not a consistent thing in Jesus' life, because not all the things in his life he was able to do.
In his life?
He asked God in the garden the day before he was crucified.
Yes, I know that.
For things to change, but nothing happened. He fulfilled the thing. What God said.
First, I'll answer your first question, then I'll come to your second. Your first question is, did the man die twice? Yes. The miracles are things which are outside the natural thing. When Moses, peace be upon him, parted the sea, for the sea to part is not natural. It becomes a miracle. Correct? So similarly, when Jesus gave life to the dead, a human being dies only once. When Jesus gave life to the dead, he comes back to life. Miracle done by Almighty God. For example, a human being is born from a father and mother, right?
Yes, sir.
But Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was born miraculously without male intervention. It's a miracle from God. That does not make Jesus God. Some Christians say, no. See, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, had no father, so he's God. So the reply to that is given in Surah Imran, chapter 3, verse number 59. Inna masala Isa in the like masala Adam. Khalaqa min turab, summa qala lahu kun fayakun. The similitude of Jesus in front of Allah is like Adam, peace be upon him. He was created from dust and said, be, and it was. If you say that Jesus is God because he had no father, then Adam, peace be upon him, is a greater God. He had no mother and no father.
Please, excuse me, I'm not a Christian.
Answered your question. Yeah. If you ask a question, you should wait for the reply. When you ask a question, you wait for the reply. After I finish the reply, then you can talk. Correct? You have to follow rules and regulation.
Okay, sorry.
So when Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, with the will of God, gave life to the dead, it was a miracle. That person will die twice. Coming to Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him. You rightly said in the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, before he was put on the cross, he sweats and he prays to God. Let this cup pass away from me. Correct? He prays. Then what happens? God saves him. God saves him. When he can give life to the dead, to a common man, and when he cries to God, can't God save him? God saves him. That's the reason he doesn't die on the cross. According to the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, did not die on the cross. And I will prove it to you. If you read the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38, people come and ask Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, that please show us signs and miracles. So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says,
the son of Jonah. Evil,
brother, will you listen to me? Do you understand English?
Understand.
You're asking a question, I'm giving the reply, again you're coming in between.
Please, I was just trying to say, looked at your, was Christ really crucified? And I know it.
But if you knew, you wouldn't have asked this question.
No, but you didn't hear my question.
Brother, let me finish the answer. If you have heard my question, you would have become a Muslim by now. If you would have heard all my lectures, by now you have been giving the Shahada.
I respect your speeches a lot.
Your
lectures. I respect your lectures and I like it.
Very good. I'll come to it later on. My respects, I'll come to it later on. First, I'll give the reply. If Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, cried to Almighty God one day before he was put on the cross, what did God do? God saved him. The Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38 to 40. When people say, show us a sign, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, ye evil and adulterous generation, seeketh thee after a sign. No sign shall be given to you but the sign of Jonah. For as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. Now, every Christian knows what is the sign of Jonah. You go to Book of Jonah, 1.5 sides. You know that Almighty God asked Prophet Jonah to go to Joppa and deliver the message. But Prophet Jonah thinks that the people of Joppa will not listen to the message. He goes to Nineveh. Now, when he's going to Nineveh by the ship, a storm comes at sea. And it was the superstition at that time that if a storm comes, it's because someone had disobeyed the master. So they normally draw lots. Who's the one who disobeyed the master? So Jonah, being a prophet of God, he volunteers that I'm the one who disobeyed the master. So because he volunteers, they don't have to break his arm or leg or tie his leg. He volunteers, so they throw him overboard. Now, when they throw Jonah overboard, was he dead or alive?
He was alive, according to the Bible.
I'm asking you according to Bible and according to your knowledge. In a storm, when a human being is thrown into a sea, normal human being, when he's thrown into the raging storm in the sea, he ought to die. As far as Jonah is concerned, Jonah was dead or alive? Dead or alive when he was thrown into the sea in the storm? Dead or alive?
He was alive according to the Bible.
Alive according to the Bible. Very good. A fish comes then gobbles him up. If a fish eats up or gobbles a man, he ought to die. Was Jonah dead or alive?
Alive still, according to the Bible.
Miracle of a miracle of a miracle. He was thrown, he was alive. In the raging storm, he ought to die, does not die alive. A fish comes and gobbles them up, he ought to die, does not die alive. A miracle of a miracle. 3 days and three nights, the fish takes him around the sea. Out of suffocation, a man ought to die. Was Jonah dead or alive?
Alive, according to the Bible.
According to the Bible. Not according to Dr. Zakir Naik. Miracle of a miracle of a miracle. From the belly of the fish, Prophet Jonah prays to Almighty God. While he was praying, was he dead or alive?
Alive, according to the Bible.
Alive, according to the Bible. A miracle of a miracle of a miracle of a miracle. After 3 days, the fish vomits him out on the shore. Dead or alive?
Alive, according
alive,
to the Bible.
According to the Bible. So according to the Bible, it's a miracle of a miracle of a miracle of a miracle. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, no sign shall be given to you but the sign of Jonah. For as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. So if you read the Bible, if you understand the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was put on the cross on Friday. It was known that the Jews don't crucify on a Sabbath day, on Saturday. So before it becomes sunset, they were in a hurry to get him down. Now when they get him down, they put him in the sepulcher. In the sepulcher, according to the Bible, was Jesus dead or alive?
He was
alive. Was Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, dead or alive?
In where? On the cross or in the tomb?
In the tomb.
In the tomb, they say he resurrected according to the Bible.
Brother, I'm asking a question. When Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was put in the sepulcher, I'm asking the question, was Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, according to the Bible, dead or alive?
They say he died on the cross and he resurrected.
I'm asking you in the sepulcher. I'm asking you, what's your name? You said, I stay in Ghana. I'm asking your name. You're saying, I live in Ghana. Brother, do you understand English? I'm asking a simple question in English. In the sepulcher, in the tomb, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was dead or alive? Outside, I'm not bothered. In the tomb, was he dead or alive?
I'm not a Christian. I don't know.
So, brother, what are you?
I don't know, unless you tell me.
If you're not a Christian, what are you?
I'm not religious. I'm still looking for religion.
Oh, so you're looking for religion. Okay. Convert. So do you believe in the Bible to be the word of God?
If you don't believe,
then why should I quote the Bible?
I don't believe.
If you don't believe Bible to be the word of God, I'll quote to you Quran, which is the word of God. Even I don't believe Bible is the word of God.
To me also.
If you don't believe Bible is the word of God, even I don't believe Bible is the word of God. There are in the Bible some portions which can be the word of God. There are words of prophets. There are words of historians. There are contradictions. There is pornography. But let me complete my answer. And you're right. According to the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he was alive. So that is the reason when you're asking me from the Bible that before he was put on the cross, he prays to Almighty God. So God saves him. Because he prays to Almighty God, he does not die on the cross. He's brought down alive. And in the tomb, he's alive. He fulfills the prophecy of the sign of Jonah. That's the reason Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, wasn't crucified. He did not die on the cross. He was saved. And Almighty God raised him up alive. Brother, do you believe? Do you believe there is one God?
I believe.
MashaAllah.
I believe.
Do you believe that Jesus is God?
I don't believe, because in my African spirituality, I believe in God. But the concept of God that is brought to me is what I don't believe.
Very good. Even I do not believe Jesus is God. Brother, one more question. Third question. Do you believe Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God?
Yeah, historically, I know Prophet Muhammad existed.
No, do you believe that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God?
I know he's a messenger of God.
MashaAllah. So if you believe God is one, and if you believe Muhammad is the messenger of God, that means you're a Muslim.
No, but you see, Muslim preaches about peace. No.
The minimum two criteria.
Dr. Naik.
The minimum two criteria required for any human being to be a Muslim is he has to believe that Almighty God is one and there is no one worthy of worship except Almighty God, which you believe.
Yes,
and
sir.
The second is that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of that God.
Yeah.
So if you believe in these two things, you become a minimum level of Muslim. You can become more and more practicing later on. For example, if you're on admission, if you take admission into a school, suppose the school is St. Peter's School, the school I studied from, you become a St. Peterite. That means you become a student of that school. Now, whether you're in first standard, second standard, third standard, 10th standard, that is later. So if you take admission, you are a student of that school. So for anyone to be a Muslim, minimum two things that he should do is, he should agree God is one, and no one deserves worship except Almighty God. And second is, you should believe that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger. If you believe in these two things, then you become a minimum level of Muslim. Then you can get more knowledge, you can keep on becoming better and better and better. You can go first standard, second standard, third standard, 10th standard, bachelor, master's, PhD, that's later. So according to me, you are a Muslim. Brother, would you like to say it in Arabic?
I'm an Africa conscious being on earth.
Sorry?
I'm a conscious being on earth.
You're conscious of?
A natural being, a natural human being on earth.
Yes, you are a human being that believes Almighty God is one.
Yeah.
Believe Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of Almighty God.
Yeah.
So according to me, you are a Muslim.
Okay, that's from your view.
Yes, of course, my view only.
Yeah.
And even from your view, because you believe he's God. Muslim means a person who submits his will to God. What is the meaning of Muslim? I told in my talk. Anyone who submits his will to Almighty God and acquires peace by submitting his will to God is a Muslim. So you have submitted your will to God. You believe there is one God, correct?
I believe.
And you believe Prophet Muhammad is a messenger.
Yeah, I believe he
is a
messenger.
That means you are a minimum Muslim. You can be more practicing by following better things, other things about Almighty God. But the minimum thing that you should follow of Almighty God is believe is one and believe Prophet Muhammad is a messenger. I believe you have just entered the fold of Islam. I'm asking you the question. You said in English.
Yeah.
That there is no one worthy of worship except Almighty God. And you told that Prophet Muhammad is a messenger of God.
Yeah.
I'm asking you, would you like to say it in Arabic?
To say...
Same thing what you said in English. Would you like to say it in Arabic?
I can't speak Arabic.
No, I will help you. Because that is the language of the last and final revelation.
I would like to speak.
You like to say it?
I would like to say it.
Okay. Is anyone forcing you?
No.
You're doing out of your own
it's
free will?
It's something I believe.
Of your own free will?
Yeah, it's something
you believe
I
Muhammad
believe.
Is the messenger, peace be upon him. Your own free
I
will?
I believe he existed. And he
no one is giving you money?
No.
Okay. I said in Arabic and you repeat it.
Okay.
Ashadu.
Ashadu.
Allah.
Ilaha.
Illallah. Wa ashadu.
Wa ashadu.
Anna. Muhammadan.
Muhammad.
Abduhu.
Wa rasuluhu. For Rasul.
I bear witness. That there is none worthy of worship.
There is none worthy of worship.
Except Allah. And I bear witness. That Prophet Muhammad.
Is the messenger.
And servant of Allah. MashaAllah, you are a Muslim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you good in this world and the hereafter. I pray to Almighty God. See, once you accept it and become a Muslim, all your previous sins have been forgiven. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you good in this world and the akhirah. And I want you to read more and more so that you understand this religion better.
Yeah, I read a lot.
And I want you to see more of my DVDs. I'll ask some of the volunteers to give you books. I've got 3 books here in Kumasi. I would ask the volunteer brother Abdul Aziz to give this brother 3 of my booklets. And I would also like to present to you a copy of the Quran. Can some volunteer get me a copy of the Quran here, please? Can some volunteer get me a translation of the Quran, please? Please keep some copies of the translation of the Quran on my table. Yes, brother, can you come and take the translation, please? The brother said that may Allah bless you. And I want to thank you, brother, for saying that. Because once you accept Islam, all your previous sins have been washed away. And I request you to pray for me also. And he said, may Allah bless you. And I'd like to thank you. May Allah guide you more to the truth. And may Allah help you guide your family members and friends to the truth. And even guide this great country, Ghana, to peace, serenity, and to the truth.